Hi, my name is Sebastian from Shonko Music, and I want to show you the next part of my series about my Yamaha A3000 sampler. What I want to show you in this video is the beat change effect. And when you saw my other videos about that sampler, I will remember you that is also a very good tool for mastering your tracks. It has a very nice compressor and a three-band equalizer. In my loop, you will hear it's a loop from a track I'm working on. So I have on that loop, on the master track, an equalizer. And I go into the Yamaha sampler. But I found out that this three-band equalizer in the Yamaha unit is very powerful. And in combination with a compressor, you get a lot of punch for your music tracks. So in my eyes, it's a very underrated, very cheap sampler unit with nice features. So you will hear now a loop from my track without the compressor and three-band equalizer, and then we'll activate it. And after I activated that, I will show you then the beat change effect. So it's also very interesting and gives you the possibility for some kind of loops or music tracks to change, not the pitch, to change the tempo. But surprisingly for me is, when you hear to that, it sounds also for this unit very good. This unit is over 20 years old, and for the real-time processing part, I think it is very, very interesting to listen to that, and maybe it can give you new possibilities for your tracks or loops or ideas or something like that. So let's listen to this. I prepared a loop, so here is it. So I will activate it now. So you hear a clear difference. I think it sounds very good. So now I want to show you the beat change effect. So I will deactivate the compressor and the equalizer. And what you see here, you have the possibility for changing the beat, the range of the beat, the pitch, and the range for the pitch. I only use the beat change mode. So plus 12 means the beat goes down. I don't know why, but that's a way out function. So I activate it and you will hear it. Another loop. So in real time, I also want to change that you see that's very interesting that this unit can do stuff like that. So the beat range 7, it's okay for me. So I make it a little bit. So, okay. Do you hear the sound quality? For me, it's absolutely amazing. There's not a noise or a crackling or interruption or something like that. It sounds not 100% natural, but it sounds really, really good. And now we changed the beat and it sounds natural. But it's not the natural part, not the natural tempo. The natural tempo is here. I think this is really, really amazing. It's not a game changer or something like that, but you have this effect inside of that unit. So maybe as a notice for you, this is a V2 version. So I changed the EEPROM. Before that, it was a version 1.0, 1.5. I don't know exactly, but I found out that the version 2 has some new effects. So this is a beat change effect. And we can also listen to that with some different changes. But from now on, you will hear it's not. So also to use effects has limits. You can make completely crazy stuff. But at the end of the day, sometimes I think it's not really useful or practical or to create stuff with that. It's only for fun. So we make a little bit fun here. Okay, that sounds completely crazy. No one can use this, but it's inside and you have the possibility to change the parameter. So absolutely fine. So it's okay. Yeah, that was a part that I wanted to show you. Beside the other effects, that is all also a very interesting possibility to use that unit. You can master your tracks also, and if you want, you can use the effect a beat change. And when you listen, and based on copyrights, I cannot show you that. But when you listen to some known productions, so music that is in the charts or your favorites, and you use that real time, the beat change, it sounds sometimes very interesting. Also because you have the feeling the tempo goes a little bit down if you want to use it with as a guitar player to for a better practice to songs that you love. This is a possibility to use this. And it's very interesting for me, because when I bought the sampler, I didn't know something about that function. And I hope I could show you some new information about this unit. And it's surprisingly, in my eyes, very cheap on the used market. The most problem are the knobs. So I will show a video or load up a video how I fixed that problem. It's not too bad. I did not change the knobs, so you have other possibilities. I will show you that. It's very simple. If you are a little bit practical and have no problems to open equipment or something others to repair, to fix, it's very easy to handle that. So, and when you fix this unit maybe can support your creation. So yeah, for now I finished. I hope you get some new information, and maybe we will hear and listen us in the next videos. So see you, bye bye.